edition of WBJU's Trending. I'm Chelsea Moss.
And I'm Caitlin Under. Today we're going to be highlighting student plays on campus, and one in particular that is backed by popular demand.
That's right. This semester is going to be a really unique one because we have a bunch of plays, three to be exact, coming back that have already been performed here before, but will be either with new actors or, in one case, will be the same actors.
Very nice. And even if you've been to any of these plays in the past, each one is going to be a lot different this year with different venues, actors, and directors.
So for our four different plays of the semester, we have Tabula Rasa, which will be this Friday and Saturday. We also have It's a Wonderful Life and Christmas Carol. And we also have a new play, The Romancers.
Very nice. And Tabula Rasa is going to be this Friday night and Saturday in Rhoda Haver Auditorium. Is that correct?
Yes, that is correct. So if you got to see it last semester, it got some rave reviews, and they were actually in Stratton Hall, but now they get to be in Rhoda Haver. So really excited to see it. I didn't get to go last time because it was in conflict with Living Gallery. So I know a lot of people missed it because of that, but I'm really excited they're bringing it back.
Very nice. And then this year for It's a Wonderful Life, it's gonna be the same exact cast as last year, but also going to be a change of venue and a different director this time.
Yes, we will expect great things from that. It's an awesome cast, so I'm excited to see that as well. Well, we have Trending's very own Meredith Hamilton, who is also in Tabula Rasa this weekend, and she's here with a fellow cast member, Anna Brown, to give us some more details on Tabula Rasa. Meredith, over to you.
Thank you, Chelsea. Anna Brown is with me in the studio today to tell us about the changes that have been going on with Tabula Rasa and give us a sneak peek at what's going on behind the scenes. So, Anna, what's different about Tabula Rasa this semester now that it's in Rhoda Haver?
Well, first of all, we have a much bigger venue. We have the challenge of having a much larger set than Stratton Hall, much larger seating capacity. So it's a challenge for us to have to fill with our characters and our voices. What's different is that now we have all the options as far as technical aspects for lighting, sound, set even. So it's bigger, much more elaborate than it was last year. So it's the same story, the same characters that were known and loved last year, but on a bigger, stronger scale.
Right. And what's wrong with, what's different with the script this time?
It's actually, you mentioned script, we actually don't have a script. So what we did develop were the characters. And we went through the story and we looked at parts that may have been not as strong before or possibly confusing. And we worked on ironing those out, fleshing out the characters, making them more true to life, more developed. And so we have the same basic structure because we know the order of scenes that we have, but we don't have a set script. So we've just worked on developing and fleshing that out.
Awesome. That's awesome. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to move into our timed trivia portion of the show. You'll have 30 seconds to answer as many questions that you can that I give you. Okay? Ready?
Yes.
Here we go. How many different characters are represented in the play?
48.
Who is your favorite character that you play?
My favorite character would have to be the teenage girl.
Name two reasons why students and faculty should attend Tabula Rasa.
First of all, it poses a lot of questions that we often ask in our lives. And secondly, it's a unique aspect because it's only eight actors and 48 characters. And we flash between time periods and different struggles and situations. And it's very colorful, very memorable.
Okay, awesome. You just finished that right in time. Thank you so much for coming in, Anna Brown. Back to you, Chelsea and Caitlin.
Thank you, Meredith and Anna. We know you've put a lot of hard work into this play, and we hope it goes super well for you guys this weekend.
Well, thank you everyone for joining us today. Join us next week as we talk about Emil Pandolfi's concert for WBJU IQ Radio. For Trending, I'm Caitlin Unruh.
And I'm Chelsea Moss. Have a super weekend.